My name is Lily, and I'm a fourth year at the Perelman School of Medicine. When I was a child in Nigeria growing up, my dad was a doctor, so I had pretty early exposure to medicine. He was an OB-GYN, and so I actually was with him in the operating room a lot. So I knew pretty early on that I wanted to follow his path and go to medical school.
Hi, I'm Eden Engel-Rebitzer, and I'm a fifth-year medical student at Perelman School of Medicine. After college, I worked for the Department of Defense and Department of Veterans Affairs. I got exposure to a lot of people who were sick and suffering, and that kind of brought into relief for me that I wanted skills to help relieve suffering. I didn't want to just be an observer of suffering.
My name is Patrick Gould, and I'm a fourth year here at the Perelman School of Medicine. I originally was not planning to go to medical school. After college, I worked in consulting for a bit, and I'd always had a thought in the back of my mind that I would love to be a doctor. I always thought it would suit me. And so I did some shadowing and quickly realized that medicine was the path for me.
In my first year of medical school, I was involved with one of the student-run clinics. It's in West Philly and targets primarily a homeless population.
I volunteered with a free clinic in West Philly and also have helped out with something called the Penn Med Votes Project, which helps hospitalized patients vote on election day.
The medical education certificate happened a little bit serendipitously. I had been involved in medical education research during my gap years, and I kind of wanted a bit more of like a formal structure to understanding the frameworks that go into medical education. The other certificate I did was the Agnew Surgery Certificate, and that exposes you sort of early on to some didactic content.
I've been able to complete a dual degree in bioethics. I'm doing a Master of Bioethics along with my MD. It was a great way to supplement my med school curriculum with thinking about broader ethical issues and writing papers and working more on constructing arguments.
I think the most powerful experiences I've had in med school have all been around kind of bearing witness to patient stories. Whether that's kind of bearing witness to end of life in the ICU or literally bearing witness to the beginning of life on the labor and delivery floor.
I did a lot of surgery rotations and got to not only take care of very interesting patients, but also got to be in the operating room.
I thought I wanted to do internal medicine from the beginning of med school, and I really became confident in that decision during my clinical rotations and during some of my electives.
I'm actually applying into general surgery, which is what I thought that I wanted to do when I first got here.
I came into medical school thinking that I would be applying into emergency medicine, but what I found when I got here was that there was a kind of culture of curiosity in internal medicine that was really compelling for me.
Some of the qualities in residency programs that I have appreciated along the trail include a big sense of community.
I wanted to be in a place that saw me as a person first.
I was looking for places that put a lot of faith in their residents and were really focused on developing clinicians with a lot of autonomy.
What I'm looking forward to about match day is sort of opening that envelope and finally knowing, you know, what the last like 8 years of my life have led up to.
I am excited. I'm nervous. There's a lot riding on match day. And so I think all of med school really builds up to this moment.
So I'm really excited for match day.